Oh, the stories I could tell if I could only talk. Well, maybe I can talk. For me, it started long ago, back in 1972. It was on the flat tops of White River National Forest in Colorado. No. My memory's as tattered as I am. Let's start with the most recent hunt. Bass Hill, 2017 of December.
Well, this is a Bass Hill hunt, California, A21, 13 years to draw this hunt. As you can see behind me, there's lots of brush, bitter brush, sage, a few pinyon pine, but this is Bass Hill itself. Not the wilderness kind of hunting we used to. More like hunting Nevada. Except I'd never hunt this close to a road. About 400 yards behind me here is Highway 395. We're just into about 5 does. Let them go on up over the hill. We've seen a lot more than that though. We've seen bucks on people's front porch. A couple in the timber where I'd prefer to hunt them. But most of them are right down here in this public access to the bow hunt. What I should really say is the majority of them are in everyone's backyards around Susanville. That creates a problem.
When Diamond Peak gets belted by the snow, that's when the bucks start to go down low. Well, this is definitely what you're looking for if you can find it. Either this, or bitter brush and sage.
Well, I've come up over the top, found this little flat. My guess is that fenced off area over there is probably a guzzler. Let's go take a look. One of the things Fish and Game's done with the help of volunteer, he's put in these guzzlers. So this water gets caught whenever it rains or freezes, and it flows off over there to the east to a rain gutter.
Thank you. I've been playing with this guy all morning. Since sunup. Within about 45, 50 yards, he was bedded down. And the doe he's with got up and fed off.
Well, that's a bummer. That big guy just herded up the doe that he's with and ran her clear over the mountain. Another buck and a doe came down the ridge. He didn't want nothing to do with anybody else. He wanted that doe all to himself. Uh, 45 yards, bedded. And they get up and feed straight away from me. Not the way I had it planned. Looking at the Bass Hill and Bald Mountain. We're looking east. You know, they've got all these great coulees and great feed. They've figured out, with muzzle loading season just concluding yesterday, that they're far safer out in the middle of that disc field. You probably can't see them, but I can. There's over 100 deer down there in that one plowed field.
Man, oh man.
Well, second day of the hunt. But every time that doe was close to a big bush or to a tree and she would stop, he would go over to the tree and he would weasel his head in between those branches and lay himself down with his head right in that tree. That is a pretty smart buck.
Well, I've traveled less than a quarter of a mile this morning. By 7:30, I've seen 9 deer. Most of them around 20, 25 yards away. 4 of those were bucks. And 3 of those bucks were under 20 yards.
I'm talking quietly, because there's quite a few deer right in here. In fact, there's a buck about 70 yards over to my left. You see all these tracks?
Well, I'm tucked in here up underneath this little juniper tree, or what they'd probably refer to as a cedar here. Fourth day of hunting. We've got Ron up here helping us doing some filming, trying to get a buck on tape actually getting taken. And we've seen quite a few bucks. We've seen them in open country. We've seen them in the timber. We've seen them in juniper. I've seen them in bitterbrush, oaks. And here we've also got some mountain mahogany. So just about any of the different transition zones, we've been finding the bucks. Unfortunately, we haven't been close to any of the ones we really want to shoot. So we'll just keep after it. Well, that's not exactly true. We have been close enough to some we wanted to shoot. The biggest trouble we're having is finding that kind of buck on public property instead of private.
Decided to try these creek bottoms just off of the road. Lots of cover in here. The bucks seem to be using these lower spots.
The buck jumped the fence just down below where I've got the stand, and probably 20 yards away, 25 maybe at the most. Fork it on, of course. You can see what a guy has to resort to. I love to spot and stalk animals. But sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do. Stinking little forked horns. I guess he wasn't all that small. Had a bucket, 5 yards. Kind of crippled up in the back left, so he's pretty much a non-typical. Affected his horn growth. He's a 7x8. Well, last night, we just about got surrounded by bucks. Had bucks coming in from all different directions. Some of them with does, some of them still by themselves. It's the 28th of November. They're supposed to be in peak rut. One thing I hear is a lot of geese. One of the things we've discovered about these deer is down in the lower country, wherever there's a river wash, they'll get right in that and follow it. Follow those drainages, gives them a little extra cover. Pretty much like you'd hunt in Arizona or any place that's got those kind of river drainages. With the dawning of each day, no matter where I hunted, animals seemed to abound, yet my stick bow had yet to be drawn. Friends, on the other hand, had enjoyed success, as many animals abounded in the area. Congratulations to each of these fine hunters. I had but one day left to make it happen.
Last morning of hunting. Tell you what, you need half layered clothing out here. Temperatures between 12 and 18 degrees in the mornings. You'll be glad you got 5 layers of clothes on. Make sure a couple of those are wool. Well, let's see if we can get her done this last day. One thing you want to do is make sure that you get X on map. I found this little 40-acre piece of BLM land, and I never would have known about it if I hadn't had that program. I've seen 5 or 6 bucks on here. Actually, the nicest buck I've seen on huntable property, between 160 and 165.
This has been a late season hunt. Last November, first 2 weeks of December, supposedly during the California buck rut here at Bass Hill. What I want to tell you is it's not an easy hunt. There are lots of bucks, mostly in the 120 to 130 class, tremendous amount of three-pointers. Finding a good 4x4 on public property is tough to do. But you have to be optimistic. Every morning, 5 in the morning, all day long, till 10 at night. Long days. Optimistic. That's actually known as faith in the Bible. God tells us, run the race before you and run it well. And when we find pleasure in being out in the field and doing this, we can also give God pleasure if we give it our best. We have to have faith in Him. So as a hunter then, you know what it means to pursue something. Pursue Jesus Christ with the same zeal that you hunt with. For His trophy is a trophy of eternity.
Head out west.